This is our video on API endpoints, but before we start, please like and subscribe. An API endpoint is a location from which APIs can access the resources they need to carry out their function. They are similar to a website's URLs, which are used to locate a particular website on the internet. For an application to perform multiple tasks, it is not only enough for it to be equipped with only blocks of code, but also integration with other applications. Integration with other applications will further enhance the features and functionalities of the application. Such software integration is possible and made easier thanks to APIs. Application Programming Interface, or APIs, is a set of protocols that allow two applications to communicate with each other. If APIs are a necessary software intermediary, then what are API endpoints? Let's find out. APIs are a set of protocols that specify how two applications should interact with one another. So how do they function? The client application will send the request to the other application's API to access some resource, and the latter will deliver it. This is where API endpoints fulfill their role. When clients request a resource, they do it via an endpoint, which effectively states that the resource is available in a specific location. To efficiently use an API, you will first need to design it and then test it multiple times to ensure it works seamlessly without errors or lags. Before jumping into the main topic of how to test API endpoints, let's first get ourselves to another pivotal concept, REST API. REST establishes guidelines on how the web should be designed and represented. A REST API, often known as a RESTful API, is a form of API that adheres to these rules. Representational State Transfer REST. This means that when a client uses a REST API to request a resource, the server returns the resource's current state in a standardized format. REST APIs, in other words, respond to queries for resources by returning all necessary information about the resource in a way that clients can understand. Clients can alter existing objects on the server through REST API and even create new ones. When we talk about web APIs, we usually refer to a form of API known as a REST API, which uses HTTP methods to tell the API what actions should be taken. The following are the most frequent HTTP methods used in API requests. GET retrieves a resource, POST creates a resource, PUT updates an existing resource, DELETE removes a resource. Through the requests mentioned above, the client will design the endpoint rules. API testing can be divided into three categories: behavioral API testing, contractual API testing, solution-oriented API testing. Behavioral API testing guarantees that it performs as intended and responds appropriately to unexpected behavior. It guarantees that the RESTful API performs as expected and responds appropriately to unpredictable behavior. Contractual API testing assures that the specification specifies exactly what has been shipped via code. This is a requirement that is in the middle of the spectrum. Contractual testing guarantees that the API definition specifies what has been actually sent via code. Solution-oriented API testing verifies that the API as a whole is capable of supporting the use cases for which it was created. This is the highest value, which is primarily external. Solution-oriented testing ensures that the API as a whole is capable of supporting the use cases for which it has been created. API endpoints should be evaluated regularly early on in the development process. The earlier you start, the better. To identify an API endpoint, all you have to do is dig further into the API documentation. Endpoints are sometimes presented in a simple list, each with a brief description. The documentation for more sophisticated APIs, on the other hand, can be pretty extensive. So let's look at how we can find some more information about APIs. So I've just opened our website here, and what you can do is you can use the developer tools to inspect some of this information in a bit more detail. And to find the developer tools, you can just go to the three dots at the top, and it's more tools and developer tools. In Firefox, it's slightly different. I'm using Chrome here now, but you can find the information online, or you can find it on our blog post about API endpoints. Now, as you can see, there's nothing here now in the network tab. So I actually go into the network tab. This is where you can find everything. If it's not open, you know, there's like two arrows here usually, and if it might be hidden in this submenu. Now we can just refresh the page. And yeah, refreshing the page will show you now, actually, if generally it's on all and it will show you a lot of information. So what I would do is just go to the fetch slash XHR tab. So that will just show HTTP requests. And then let's just pick one. So for example, this one here. This this is what the window will show you a lot of detailed information about the HTTP requests. It will give you the request URL, and as you can see here, there is actually it says actually here API dot. So this is definitely an API call, and the URL. So this URL up to, let's say, the question mark, which defines the URL parameters. This would be the API endpoint. So the URL to find the API. Now we can see request method we used. So in this instance, we used the get to just retrieve some information. We can see what the status code was. So it was 200, which means success. There's some other information in the response from the server. So what options are available, some access controls, stuff. And if we look at, for example, the other tabs, so you can see a payload, you can see that we sent some information to the API, which is an ID that is part of the URL here that we invoked. So we are actually using a get parameter that we define, which is just some ID. You can preview the response, which you can see here, and the actual response in the response tab. And this will show you if it's, for example, a RESTful API, it's usually a JSON response. So it is a JSON object. If you using a SOAP API, it would show different. So it would most likely show XML information. You can see some timing around that as well. And yeah, this is how you can find out some more about APIs that websites use. It'll give you some insights into what the responses are and what methods you can use. So this was our video on API endpoints. And if you want to learn more about coding for free, please find the link to our 5-day coding challenge in the description below.